First time patella dislocation when we consider surgery. My name is Dr. Pirun Tang Sipong from Nalesuan University Hospital Orthopedic Department. Outline, blackout review, anatomy, bony and soft tissue stabilizers, radiographic evaluation, predicting risk factor for recurrent lateral patella dislocation, treatment option for first time lateral patella dislocation. Incident, acute traumatic patella dislocation is the second most common cause of traumatic knee arthrosis, and it accounts approximately 3% of all knee injuries. An annual incident of 23.2 per 10,000 person year is typically result from a sport injury and occurred in young active patient under the age of 20. The mechanism, non-contact injury with knee rotation and vulcan load on fixed foot. 30 to 70% with residual pain or recurrent instability and potential for progression of damage to articular cartilage. Concomitant injuries. 98% of patients demonstrate MPFL rupture at MRI. 85% of patients show signs of patellar chondral damage. And trochlear chondral injury were 47% of patients. The intra-articular loose body were observed in 11.5% of the patients. Then consider MRI as time of first lateral patellar dislocation and assess anatomical risk factor for recurrent lateral patella dislocation. Stability of patellofemoral joint is maintained by the compact interaction of three stabilizing groups. First, static stabilizers, bony structures, trochlear group morphology, patella height, tibial tubercle position, limb alignment and rotation, active quadriceps femoris muscle, and passive soft tissue stabilizers. WMO is the most important dynamic stabilizers. MPFL, MPTL, medial retinaculum, and lateral soft tissue is second static stabilizer. Medial patellofemoral complex, MPFC, consists of MPFL and MQTFL. They act as main medial patellar stabilizer from 0 to 30 degree of knee flexion. And primary resistant against lateral patellar dislocation and provide 50 to 60% of medial restraining force against such translation. Anatomic risk factor for lateral patellar dislocation. The major risk factor, trochlear dysplasia, patella alta, increased TTTG distance, abnormal patella tilt, MPFL insufficiencies, and the other risk factor are shown in this picture. Trochlear dysplasia is a major factor. Its high predictive value for recurrent patella dislocation. The two classification describe three qualitative signs on perfect lateral radiograph. The causing sign, trochlear bump, and double contour sign, but its low inter-observer reliability. Trochlear dysplasia divided into two groups, mild type A and severe type B to D. Patella height, patella alta. Patella alta require more knee flexion prior to patella engaging the trochlea. Frequency use in soft supporting ratio, but inconsistent in skeletally immature. Katong de Chong, better intra-inter-observer reliability and not dependent on knee flexion angle. Tibial tubercle trochlear group TTTG distance. MRI may underestimate 3.8 mm compared to CT scan. The normal range 9 to 30 mm. More than 15 to 20 mm suggests cut-off abnormal. And also use TT-PCL distance In the patient who had abnormal bony morphology affected trochlear groove, the normal distance 8 to 15 mm. More than 20 to 24 mm suggests cut-off abnormal. Management of first traumatic lateral patella dislocation. Non-operative treatment was indicated in the vast majority of the patients. The outcome can summarize as follows. 1/3 done well with return to previous level of function. 1/3 recurrent instability and require surgery. And 1/3 no recurrent dislocation, but have had persistent symptoms, including pain, apprehension, and giving way episode, or inability to return to pre-injury level of activity. Recommend weight bearing as tolerated and using splint or brace during the first 4 weeks, with range of motion 0 to 60 degrees of flexion. A posterior splint might be the best option because of low redislocation rate and knee joint restriction. They did not find a significant difference in the relocation rate among cylinder cast splint and brace group. A systematic review and meta-analysis comparing conservative and the surgical treatment for acute lateral patella dislocation was not superior to conservative treatment in terms of clinical outcome, including redislocation, Kujala score, thickness score, and subjective result. The result indicates that conservative treatment may be a preferable option for primary lateral patella dislocation, especially in the term of pain. Routine surgical treatment is not advocated for treating acute lateral patella dislocation. Predictors of recurrence after acute lateral patella dislocation. The graph shows overall recurrence-free survival rate is 50% at 5 years. And on the right side, the risk factor, if you have more risk factor, open physis or trochlear dysplasia, the recurrence rate up to 75%. A risk assessment and management of primary lateral patella dislocation is complex and multifactorial. A survey of Australian knee surgeon. Three factors, trochlear dysplasia, patella alta, and younger age, regarded as significantly increasing the risk of recurrent patella dislocation, are supported by synthesis literature. Furthermore, the two highest rank factors, history of contralateral recurrent patella dislocation and a traumatic injury mechanism, are without a significant evidence base. They recommend operative treatment of lateral patella dislocation after a third episode. MPFL reconstruction was the most frequently used, followed by tibial transfer procedure. Patella instability severity score or PIS score, the risk factor including age, bilateral instability, trochlear dysplasia, patella height, TTTG distance, and patella tilt. The odds ratio for recurrence are 5 times higher when total score more than 4 points. Another, Jaquit et al. Evaluated multiple risk factors to estimate the recurrence rate after first time lateral patella dislocation in the patient less than 18 years old. The presence of two or more factors would increase the risk of recurrent instability greater than 50%. The risk factor, the trochlear dysplasia and history of contralateral dislocation weighed heavily. Another risk factor are skeletal immature and Kathong De Chong more than 1045. This algorithm for primary lateral patella dislocation. First time patella dislocation, radiograph using MRI if applicable. Long leg radiograph, torsional CT or MRI. And using PIS score and the number of risk factors and flag fracture. If the patient no flag fracture, PIS score lower than 3 or 0 to 1 risk factor, conservative treatment. But if the PIS score more than 4 or more than 2 risk factor, consider primary operative treatment. And the left side, if the flag fracture and PIS score more than 4 or more than 2 risk factor, flag refixation, MPFL reconstruction, and consider further procedure to correct additional risk factor. Take home message. Conservative treatment is mainstay of treatment after first time lateral patella dislocation without osteochondral fracture. Risk factor can be evaluated by using PIS score more than 4, younger age, bilateral instability, trochea dysplasia, increased patella height, increased TTTG distance, and increased patella tilt. In the patient with high risk profile, primary surgical treatment should be considered in order to prevent osteochondral injury. Thank you for your attention.